Detective Yu Guanming, Special Case Squad.
I want to report a homicide on the Bailey Canal. There was this big plastic bag, and I could see her hair. A young woman. She's naked, dead.
Hold on, let me see who's available.
Hello? Detective?
Everyone's out now, even Inspector Chen. But I can come. Whereabouts on the canal are you?
West of Jingpu, about 7 miles past Shanghai number 2 paper mill.
Wait for me there, and don't touch anything.
Inspector Chen, Death of a Red Heroine, by Qiu Xiaolong, dramatised by Joy Wilkinson.
$13 million people live in Shanghai. Families of two or three generations squeezed into single rooms. It's not surprising some people at the bureau aren't happy with me. A single man gets allocated an entire apartment ahead of those with longer service or large families. They think it's another instance of the unfair new carder policy. Another instance of Inspector Chen's good fortune. The educated youth who had been spared re-education in the countryside, allowed to stay in the city and learn English, handed a good job at the Shanghai Police Bureau with opportunities, privileges. That's how it seems to them anyway. But things are never that simple. I try not to think about it. Put their complaints out of my mind and concentrate on the cooking for my housewarming party.
Sorry I'm so early. I escaped as soon as my copy was filed. Couldn't wait to have a look around.
Oh, make yourself at home. I'm nearly done here.
Wang Feng, my first guest. A reporter from the Wenhui Daily. A friend. Maybe more.
Congratulations, Chief Inspector Chen. What a spacious apartment.
I'm glad you like it.
And a bathroom, too.
It's just a shower pipe. Cold water, but yes, I'm lucky. Would you like some Shoxing wine?
Look at that view. It's almost like a picture.
You turn it into an artwork. Standing there, waist so slender, weightless. She dances on my palm.
What's that?
An image from Li Yu, the poet emperor. He feared his favourite concubine would break in two if he held her too tightly. His line fails to do justice to you.
More bogus compliments from the Tang dynasty. Thank you, my poetic chief inspector.
Poetically alone.
Now you have your own place, there's no excuse for you to stay celibate.
Well, introduce some girls to me then.
You need my help. You're a rising political star.
Thanks to your article.
The People's Policeman. Saving the city by day and toiling into the night. Translating poetry and mystery novels to broaden the horizon of his expertise.
Are you sure that's my motivation?
I'm sure the extra cash comes in handy. But no. I think you do it for the love.
It's been over a year since we met.
Time is a bird. It perches and it flies.
That's one of mine.
Parting. You must have been parted from someone very dear to you.
You must know what that's like, Wang Feng.
You should get it. Could be one of your guests.
Hi, Chen speaking.
It's Detective Yu Guanming, Special Case Squad, reporting a homicide. A young woman's body in a canal west of Qingpu County.
I'll be on my way.
No need, Inspector. I've already examined the scene. I just wanted to let you know that I came. There was no one else to take the case.
That's okay. Even if it's not a special case, we should respond if no one else is available.
I'll make a more detailed report tomorrow morning. Please excuse me if I'm disturbing you in your new apartment.
Don't mention it, Detective Yu. I'll see you tomorrow.
Are you all right? Has something happened?
A new case at work, but it's been taken care of.
And here are your other guests. Let the party begin!
The zither, for no reason, has half of its strings broken. One string, one peg, evoking the memory of the youthful years. The party goes on around me, but all I can think of are those lines. Why? Because of the murder case? The young woman? A life wasted in its prime? The broken strings. the lost sounds. Was it about her? Or me? Nothing here is simple. Chinese carders used to rise slowly, step by step. If someone reached a high level, they could stay there till the end. Now the new rules mean they have to retire. Someone young and educated can get promoted, move faster. The head of the Bureau's homicide department has retired, but no successor has been announced yet. I've been put in charge of the special case squad to prove myself.
Good morning, Chief Inspector Chen. Here, my report.
You must have worked late last night, Detective Yu.
And early this morning.
Go and get yourself some tea while I read this.
Thank you, Inspector.
The body. A dead woman. Nameless. Naked. Found in a black plastic bag on Bailey Canal. Late 20s, early 30s, 5'4", around 110 pounds. Toenails painted scarlet. No rings on her well-manicured fingers. It's possible that she had sexual intercourse before her death. Only a faint line of bruising around her neck. Barely visible. No signs that she had struggled much. Possible cause of death? Strangulation in combination with sexual assault.
We got the first photos through. She can't have been in the water long. 20 hours or so.
What do you think happened to her, Detective Yu?
Raped and murdered on a boat and dumped in the canal. Or raped and murdered somewhere else and then transported to the canal.
Not on a boat. There'd be no need to wrap the body.
Then it could have happened anywhere.
Have you checked the missing persons list?
No one fits a description. What do you think happened?
Nothing's definite until we've had the full forensics report. Maybe it was a taxi driver. We've had similar cases. But again, why would he need to use a bag?
Maybe he just happens to have one in his car.
It could have been an acquaintance who used the bag to move the body to the car from the crime scene.
Not too many people have their own cars. Only high carders. And a chauffeur wouldn't get involved in this.
The number of private cars is growing. We can't rule it out. Let's say the murderer was an acquaintance. The next question is, why? Was it a secret affair? Was she pregnant?
Definitely not. And they always are in those cases. Almost without exception.
Almost.
There's nothing we can do until we know her identity. I could check with the taxi bureau, but there's at least 10,000 taxis in Shanghai.
What do you think we should do, Detective?
Do we have to take the case?
Well, that's a good question.
I only took the call because no one else was here. It's not a so-called special case. Nothing political about it. We have no clues or witnesses. It's already cold, and our squad is short of men right now. There's only really you and me.
I'll talk to Party Secretary Lee. You, get this photo. Cropped and circulated, someone might recognise her. And I'll go out to the canal later.
It's a poetic scene. You might be inspired to write a few wonderful lines.
You never can tell.
Detective Yu doesn't know the full story behind my good fortune. Once I was a published poet and a top student at Beijing Foreign Language Institute. Then I applied to an MA program in English and American Literature. But I was informed that a job had been assigned to me in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. They said it was a good job for an English major. I should count myself lucky, even though I had no interest in being a diplomat. But at the last minute, a check revealed my uncle was a counter-revolutionary in the 1950s. This made my diplomatic career politically unthinkable. I was assigned to the Shanghai Police Bureau instead, writing political reports for Party Secretary Lee. I only became a proper cop 2 years ago. I've done my best, but my academic past, my rapid rise, and my literary pursuits, they don't endear me to people like Detective Yu. I have to prove myself to him, too.
Is everything satisfactory with your new apartment, Comrade Chief Inspector?
Everything's good, thank you, Party Secretary Lee.
And your work on the squad?
A murder case came in yesterday. We're wondering if we should take it.
Turn it over to Homicide.
Detective Yu went to the scene. It feels like it's ours.
You may not have time for it. I found out this morning. You've been chosen to attend the Central Party Institute seminar in Beijing in October.
Really?
A great opportunity, isn't it? I recommended you.
You've done so much for me, Party Secretary Lee. In fact, that's another reason for us to take this case.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.